You didn't have to come home to sleep an hour ago.
Yeah, I guess we're both nice guys.
I guess.
Lou takes a third of a bet, and you bring in tasty spread. I'm hunting with a bunch of faggots, for God's sake.
Country, you know.
Is this going to be a long story?
And, State Department has put out this, word.
Hey, you know, son, I don't understand you.
Treat this son of a bitch with respect, you know. Because, who knows, maybe we can, kind of clean up the Cold War a little bit, you know. So he called up a beautiful hen, and he said, honey, meet me over at the penthouse and so on, and they ring the doorbell, and the ambassador himself opened the door, and he said, took one look. He says, you go home. Come, darling, come with me. Took her right in the bedroom. Hurry up, quick, take off the clothes. She starts disrobing, you know, and suddenly he stops and he looks up underneath her armpit and he says, wool, where's the wool here? And she says, wool? He says, oh, you mean hair? He says, yeah, you know, the wool. He says, well, you see, here in the United States, the women shave because it's neater and cleaner. So she took off the rest of her clothes, and man, he's standing there armed and ready, you know? He looked her up and down, and suddenly he spotted, and he says, but wool, where's the wool? And she looked at him for a moment. She says, tell me, mister, did you come here to fuck or knit?
Oh. All right. Who's watching the time?
An hour and 48 minutes.
48? Come on.
I'm back on you. You're really an asshole. If you'd have taken the bet, you'd have won.
Your ass is the prize.
Okay, baby.
The prize. Hey.
I'm here's give your me the prize.
Here's your ass.
Hey, Zeke.
Yo,
it's your hill, buddy.
Hey, I didn't touch my ass over tea kettle.
Hey, you know, my asshole still hurts.
Want me to tell you something? Not only my asshole.
Hey, wait a minute. Thank God we had the
spot. You want to remember it, Zeke.
It was right here, wasn't it?
Smell that air, boy.
Oh, boy.
Beats the fifth out of the city. I tell you, for example.
Pollution beats the city. Right.
Yeah. Pollution.
Hey. That's nice. Good.
Deer shit back there.
Oh, deer shit. I'm telling you, it's all hippie shit.
Hippie shit.
What makes you think it was hippie shit?
Because there was long hair in it.
What do you got there?
What are you going to do with my bag?
To hold it.
To hold what?
A rudder for a duck stash, you asshole.
Dumb bastard.
I guess I walked into that one.
You ask silly questions, that's what you get.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh. Silly answers.
Hey, fellas, don't you think we should pack it in?
Awful.
Huh?
I don't know.
Yeah. We've been plowing around all day. We haven't seen a bloody thing.
Ah, but what a hell of a day, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Pete.
If there aren't any animals, what the hell are we doing here?
I don't know. Hmm? What the hell are we doing out here? Rex?
Come out to shoot.
Yeah, but if you got nothing to shoot at...
What difference did it make?
No, there are no animals. There's nothing to shoot.
I don't really see the point of it, you know?
Not a drop to drink.
doing about now. Hell, even the bullfrog.
Somebody find a beer can. Toss that in the air. We'll shoot at it.
Are you kidding? Haven't you heard? Beer cans are an endangered species, my boy.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm starving.
Yeah, what the hell you got to eat back at the lodge, Rex?
Steaks.
Hey, well, come on. Ah!
Hey, come on.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Come on.
Hey, don't forget, I'm not cooking this week. I'm glad. Give it up there. Ah, hold it.
They look just like us.
Gun.
All clear, Zeke?
Look that way!
Keep a lookout.
How you doing?
Oh, they just christened me, that's all.
Bandage on.
Oh, no, no, fine, I'm fine.
Well, you picked your health today.
Pete, you all right? Huh? Can you believe those bastards?
Can you believe us?
What the hell are you talking about? They started it, didn't they? Huh?
One of their guys is dead.
God, look at that blood.
Hold it, hold it, hold it.
Oh,
hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Did you see somebody?
No, it's just some kids.
We're going to report the shooting from here, aren't we?
Yeah, we can wait till we get to Pembroke. We got a hospital there.
It's a good idea.
Either way, let's get rid of the hard way. We look out the goddamn Dalton gate. Here, put that pistol. Don't anybody see you.
My God, I never saw anything like that in my whole goddamn life.
Well, that son of a bitch just took it into his head all of a sudden to plink me.
You know, he must have gone temporarily insane. How else could you explain a situation like that?
Well, he's not going to go around plinking anybody anymore.
You sure took care of him for me, buddy.
Hey, did you see that? Right between the eyes.
Prettiest offhand shot I've ever seen. Wish I could get off a shot like that. I can't really believe it happened.
It happened. It really happened.
He sure as hell deserved it.
Oh, you're telling me.
Yeah.
What are we stopping here for?
I'm gonna check it out first.
How many rounds did you get off about?
Oh, I emptied her.
You really pumped it out, eh?
I wish the hell I had it in my heavy piece.
I wish the hell I'd had a Tommy gun.
How many rounds did you throw at him, Lou? Hey, Lou.
Huh?
How many rounds did you throw?
Oh, I don't know.
Where did you shoot?
Sure, I shot.
You weren't scared, were you?
Well, what kind of a question's that?
I just wondered. Well, I wasn't scared. What the hell's the matter with you?
Nothing's the matter.
The truth. All I want to know is, what are the cops going to do to us when we report this?
Not a damn thing.
When we tell them that Zeke killed... When we tell them that we killed a guy back there?
Nothing.
For killing a guy?
You mean, what are the cops going to do to them, don't you, Lou?
Well, what are they going to do to us? String us up for defending ourselves?
Not a judge of the country who'd blame us for shooting back.
I'm not so sure.
Oh, what the hell does he know anyway? He runs a lousy print shop.
You sell used cars. What's that got to do with anything?
The only man he doesn't know any more about the law than we do.
What are you trying to say, Lou? There's no such thing as self-defense. Is that what you're trying to say?
That's crazy.
No, wait a minute. What are you trying to say?
Well, I can't say. I mean, it's not as simple as just self-defense.
Oh, you're a cheerful bastard, aren't you?
Yeah, you sure got a lot of laughs.
Look, I'm just facing facts. A man was shot dead.
And how he was shot dead. The shit I hit him with was like peanut butter. His brain should be all over Lincoln County now.
Hey, give me another belt, will you? This head is beginning to throw up now.
The mood I'm in, I feel like turning around and going after him. Chasing us off our own territory.
The hell were they anyway? We ever see him before?
Oh, who knows? Everybody looks the same in the woods.
I sure as hell like to find out who they were.
Well, you'll find out soon enough. Don't worry.
Is that right, Louis?
They're not gonna tell a damn thing to us.
I'm glad you think so.
What do you think they're gonna do, Lou?
I don't know. These guys think we'll report it, and the cops will say thanks, and that'll be the end of it. Well, I think it's just the beginning.
Why?
I keep telling you why. A man has been killed. It makes no difference how it happened. Look, there's bound to be a big stink about this. Look, you want to know something? That ambulance that just left here could be spooning them up right now.
What the hell are you so worried about?
According to you, I killed him. Oh, horseshit! Horseshit, my ass!
I got an idea. Now, what if we just get him to fix my head here and don't tell him about the shootout?
Hospital's got to report all gunshot wounds.
Somebody's got to do something. This son of a bitch is really burning now. Damn smart, you tell us what to do. I don't know what the hell. Hell, we shot.
5 years in a goddamn bed. That's what I'll do.
I know what I'd like to do. Go home and get out of these clothes and soak in a bathtub for an hour.
This has been one kind of a motherfucking weekend. I spent a solid day farting around in the woods, and I don't even see a rabbit.
And I'm the lousy guy that winds up with a hole in his head you can whistle through. Bullshit. And I get 10 years for murder.
What about my head? If somebody doesn't fix it soon, they'll have to amputate.
Rex? Rex. Rex. You're the senior officer present. What do you think we should do?
That's right, Major. What do we do?
Due respect to Pete's bleeding head and Lou's bleeding heart, the first thing we're going to do is get the hell out of here.
Since Beth filed for divorce, don't knock it. It's all I can afford.
Who's knocking it? Hunter's liberation.
Want to do it here, Doc?
Yeah, this is as good place as any. You got to clean cloths and put it.
Yeah, get him a towel or something.
Yeah, sure.
Sorry, I can't get the glove.
Oh, never mind that. I take that.
You going to use a needle?
How do you feel about lockjaw?
No offense, Doc, but maybe if you were a regular doctor instead of a veterinarian, I'd feel better.
Just a little tetanus booster before we try to clean it out.
Just relax, Pete. The last time you used that needle was in a horse's ass.
How about this, Doc? Huh?
That's good.
Hold it. Okay, Doc.
Oh.
the 11 o'clock news. That's three channels and three goose eggs.
Are we going to report it or not?
None. No?
Not unless they do. Not unless they do, and I don't think they're going to.
But they'll have to. They don't have any choice.
Wait a minute. I didn't say they weren't going to report it. They've got to report it. A man was killed, for Christ's sake. I'm saying they're not going to report it as a shootout. They're going to report it as an accident.
Wow.
Beautiful. A hunting accident. Now, you think about that. Every day a hunting accident, right? No big investigations, no problems. Everybody's happy, right?
Wrong. In the first place, they'll figure that we'll report it, especially a shootout.
I don't think so. I think they think we're going to just shut up and wait.
Hell, it must have been some party while it lasted.
Poor chap, Hill, all over again.
What'd you know? One time there was some excitement. I had to stay up all night delivering a mirror miss out on it.
You know, Rex, if you're wrong about those guys not reporting the shootout, we'll be worse off than if we'd gone to the police in the first place.
Not necessarily. They started it, remember? But if I'm right, we're free and clear. It's worth taking a chance.
Rex, I'm with you.
Same here. We could sweat it out for a month.
No. If they're going to report it, they're going to report it quick.
All you have to do is listen to the news.
Oh, for crying out loud. Do you think they report everything on that damn tube?
We'll check the local papers tomorrow morning. If we don't see anything there, we'll check every goddamn paper in the state.
That's a good idea. That's some shut-eye. You guys want to meet here again tomorrow?
No, you got too many neighbors. We'll meet in my store. Nobody's there Sunday morning. 8 o'clock, all right with you guys?
Yeah, all right.
What about you bastards? Wish I had every piece with me.
Wish I'd had time again.
Now listen. We keep our story straight. Now remember, not a word to anybody, not even your wives, particularly not your wives. Anybody ask about Pete's wound? He fell down a ravine, hit his head on a rock. Okay? Lou?
Yeah, sure.
Night, Jim. Have a night.
We'll see you.
She insisted on waiting up when I told her you were coming home.
You weren't boozing while she was still awake.
I promise.
Do you remember a dentist appointment?
Uh-huh. Just like the TV commercials. The old cavities. How bad was it?
What do you mean?
Whatever brings you home on a Saturday night?
Yeah, nothing to shoot. I'm thinking of selling the lodge.
I thought maybe it was that time of the month for your friend.
You want to discuss that?
No. No. I don't want to discuss it, period. After all, it is me who's hanging on.
Anytime you want out, Ellen.
No, I prefer it this way. Rex? I really do.
vice president in charge of sales for Ames Fiedler. He's been there for a year. Been there for a year, but let's him off.
They clean up Pembroke?
Yeah. Across Reed City, Parlorville.
Hey, where you been? You're late.
Never mind. First. Now look, I got a possible in the Sterling Town Crier.
Let's hear it.
All right. 49 years old, graduate of Annapolis, military background, right? Guns.
Come on, come on.
The country was in the Army or Navy.
Guns.
I'm not finished. Mr. Gidding, industrialist and sportsman, received an honorary degree last June from his alma mater, West Kansas State University.
Forget him. That's a black school.
Well, how do you know?
I follow basketball, remember?
Well, well, if that's it, home and mother.
You know, I think I'm starting to feel better about this whole thing.
Yeah? Well, we're not out of it yet.
Are you going to start that shit again?
No, he's right. We got to hang tough and keep in touch. And sooner or later, they're going to have to file a death certificate.
I wish I'd been there to give you a little added firepower. See you, Rex.
See you later, Rex.
So long, Rex.
I'll take care of that, Lou.
Okay. I'll see you.
Yeah, you really turned the place around. I can remember when you could jam the whole inventory into the basement.
Yeah, the old man was pretty conservative.
Yeah, maybe so. He had enough sense to let his daughter marry the ultimate crap shooter. Yeah, I've got to hand it to you. You've made this into a real organization. Which is what I wanted to talk to you about. Paula's been all over me again. She gets bored around the house.
Yeah, well, I guess that's the price you have to pay for marrying a young filly. Huh?
Well, there are compensations. I don't want her bothering you.
Why would she bother me?
Well, she's got that cosmetics job on the brain. She saw that classified you're running in the Herald.
Tell her to fill.
I won't stop her. She may ask you for another interview.
All right, so I'll send it to personnel. Don't worry about it.
I just don't want her bugging you, that's all.
Don't worry about it.
Is this Mrs. Graham, Mrs. Ed Graham? Yes, Mrs. Graham. You don't know me. My name is Sutton, Mr. Frank Sutton. Well, I was a friend of Ed's at Northwestern years ago.
Yes, ma'am. I read about it in the local newspaper.
No, I don't. I don't live in Clinton. I was just passing through here on business, but I know this is a bad time for you, and I thought perhaps I could pay my respects. Well, that would be very nice, ma'am. Yes, I have the address.
It's a marvelous service, I can tell you that much.
I'm glad to hear that, Mrs. Graham.
I've never seen so many flowers.
Must have been beautiful.
Of course, it was a military service because Ed was a veteran. Many decorations. And of course, he was past commander of the local legion here. That's why they gave him such a wonderful send-off this afternoon. Can you tell I've been drinking?
Beg your pardon?
Well, when you telephoned, I was in my room with the door locked, sitting on my bed, stark naked. I've already had 3 scotches.
Well, that's all right.
I switched to sherry for your benefit.
Well, I can go either way.
Oh, yes? Really? You see, when you called, I wasn't even going to answer the phone, but then I thought it might be Marshall calling to say he was on his way over. Marshall? Well, surely you must have heard of Marshall Flynn.
Oh, yeah, it rings a bell.
Yes, well, he was Ed's roommate at North Western.
Oh, yeah, that's it, yeah.
Marvelous man, Marshall. He was a one-man army against the Japs. He and Ed were very close. Thank you. They loved to go hunting together. And of course they were together on Saturday.
When it happened?
Ed and Marshall and a bunch of their hunting buddies. Just the other side of the Stirrup River. When a bullet came from the trees, from the clearing on the other side of where they were standing, killed him instantly. A stray bullet, according to Marshall.
Well, I'm sure that's true. I can't imagine anyone wanting to hurt Ed deliberately.
That's exactly what Father Bernard said at the service today, that Ed was so full of love. Oh, he loved his guns and his hunting and being out in the woods with his buddies. Oh, so much love. Are you a hunter, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, then I don't have to explain anything to you. But then he had to put up with all that bleeding heart gump from his own son. Who, by the way, did not even make an appearance at the service today.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right. The Honorable Edward M. Graham, Jr. The youngest assemblyman in the history of the state. But do you know who elected him? The hippies and the junkies and the jigs. Not to mention the ecology nuts and the anti-gun nuts. Just shows you how much power they have these days. Dad was an embarrassment to him because he remained president of the Clinton Rifle Club. Well, now, what is it they say in the Constitution, in the Second Amendment? Quote, the right of the people to keep and
bear arms.
Unquote. All that gump, Jr. threw down his throat. The hunt is hurting willfully the wildlife. Well, Dad just said to him, why don't move to India? Whether they worship animals there. They let the cattle shit in the street so the cars just can't get along.
Yeah.
But I don't suppose I have to tell you what's behind that, do I?
No, you don't. You certainly do not. Well, I have a guard meeting tonight. I think I'd really better be going.
It has nothing to do with wildlife. You see, it's all part of a great plot to disarm the American household. So then the hippies and the junkies and the jigs can come in whenever they like and beat you half to death and rape you. While their buddies downstairs are taking out the TV sets so they can sell them and buy more heroin. What do you say to that?
I say you're right. Dead right.
Well, I have news for you. Do you know what I have in my bedroom beside my night table?
What?
The sweetest little Smith & Wesson 357 you ever saw in your life. And I know how to use it. You better believe that.
That makes sense.
And don't you dare tell me that that wouldn't stop a man. The first junkie or hippie or jig that walked through that door would get it right between the eyes. Would you believe that I haven't got on any underwear underneath this outfit? Well, now, don't you want me to say something to Marshall for you? He'll be here any minute.
No, I don't think he'll remember. It's been years, but again, my condolences. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Do you understand?
Father, I am flagged. Forward. Who?
You weren't that bad, Rex.
I got more important things on my mind than worrying about those clowns.
What's the matter? Bad news? Have you heard something?
I think we're out of the woods, don't you, Lou?
What do you mean?
I mean, it's been 2 days now. I think we're over the hump, don't you think? Right? I mean, for now, over the hump, right?
Right.
Wrong. Just because they didn't report it doesn't mean they're not looking for us.
Looking for us? What are you talking about?
What do you think I'm talking about?
Looking for us for what?
So you know what.
Oh, God. Oh, come on. I don't believe it, and you don't either.
Think about it, Lou. What if Pete had been killed? Did you have reported it?
anymore.
Sure.
Right away, right?
Absolutely.
So would I. So why didn't they report it? One of their men was killed. Why didn't they report it?
Well, because I think
about it, Lou.
Well, I believe they realized that we were shooting back in
self-defense?
Right.
Or shit. They didn't report it, Lou, because they want to handle it their own way.
In their own way? What do you mean?
Listen, Lou, you're a realist. You're the first one I've talked to about this. This doesn't just concern you, or me, or the fellas. This concerns our families. This concerns our kids, maybe even our friends. Now, how long have I known you? 20 years? Have I ever lied to you?
No.
Ever?
No.
All right, well, I'm not lying to you now. I'm telling you the way it is. I'm telling you those bastards are out to get us.
Jesus Christ. You really think they try to bushwhack us?
I know. I think those bastards are going to be waiting for us Saturday.
This is a civilized country, for crying out loud. These are civilized people.
Civilized, for Christ's sake. Try to kill us, for Christ's sake. Is that civilized?
I don't know. I swear. I know two things, Lou.
I know two things. I know one. We're running out of time, and I know, too, we better be prepared. Now, you think about that, Lou.
Sir.
Be right there, Sergeant.
Be prepared.
You think about that.
Hut! Hut! Hurry! Oh, hut! Hut!
Morning, Helen.
You've got company inside, yes.
Who's that?
Bob's wife.
What the hell is she doing here?
She was distracting everyone out here, men and women.
Anything else?
Nothing that can't wait.
All right, call me in 5 minutes, okay?
Good.
What's the coffee?
Please.
Black?
Mm-hmm.
Bob said you might be coming by. About that cosmetic job.
I thought you already had filled it.
Yep, I have.
Then we'll just have to talk about something else.
Another department?
Anything else.
Bob doesn't want you to work, Paula. He kind of puts me in the middle of it.
That's fine. I didn't come to talk to you about a job.
No.
No. I just wanted to see you. How does that sound?
Sounds like you're looking for trouble.
Maybe I am.
Bob's a friend of mine, Paula.
I know. And I like his taste.
You don't know me.
I'm trying to crack that.
Don't.
Why not? You like me. I like you. When I first met you, I thought there's a real man. I didn't care about that silly job.
Finish your coffee and get on.
I want you, Rex. And you can have me. Anytime. Any place.
You don't listen, do you?
I'm listening. But I need you. Besides, I'm leaving Bob.
Does he know that?
I haven't told him yet. But he knows it.
He's crazy about you.
And I'm not very crazy about him. He's just a rather nice man who doesn't turn me on. Call me tonight.
Okay. think about it.
Don't think about it. Do it.
Nick, Peter.
Mr. Springer's in.
Thanks.
Lou was here already.
He really got shook up.
He was here? What did he say?
He said that you think those guys are coming after us.
What else did he tell you?
He said that you overreacted.
Did he tell you I saw the guy's widow?
No shit. Find her.
I found her. Seek, I don't think I know. Those bastards are after us.
You know what I told him? I told him that if they come after us, that's the biggest mistake they'll ever make.
What'd he say?
Well, you know what it was. I'm excited. He gives me a pain in the ass.
I think I got a right to talk to people.
You got a right to keep your goddamn mouth shut. When I want to tell somebody something, Lou, I don't want you to do it for me.
Now, just take it easy.
Take it easy, my ass. I want to ask you something, though. Are you with me or not? Everybody else is.
Everybody?
Everybody.
Including Jim?
Including Doc. We're having a meeting tomorrow, Lou. If you're with us, be there. If not, stay the hell out.
I'm sorry, Rex. I can't be with you. Not this time.
That's what I figure.
You can figure whatever you want. But I just can't see it. I just can't see it, Rex.
Goodbye, Lou.
Sit down, Pete.
Major.
Sit down, man.
I'd like to go along.
But change your mind.
Well, Zeke told me you found out who the guy was. I'll figure it out.
figured maybe you could tell us something more.
Not a hell of a lot. Still want to go?
That's right. What was the guy's name?
How do we know you won't change your mind again, Lou?
I won't. I'm sure.
I'm not. We're going to have a little time on that. We're going to have to think about that, Lou. Maybe by that time you'll have changed your mind again, huh? Sit down, Lou. Men, we'll make this meeting brief. We've had a few days to think about what happened, and two things we know. One, they did not report the shootout.
Which goes to prove he was right, Lou.
Two, if they have any ideas of revenge or settling the score, they're going to do it in their own way, in their own time.
When?
Soon, real soon.
Where? They don't know who we are or where we live.
They know where we hunt. They know when we hunt.
That's right.
I think those bastards are going to be waiting for us Saturday. And this time, we're going to be prepared. And that's why we're here.
One question comes to me right off, Major. You guys said there were six or seven of them.
Six.
Go ahead, Jim.
You think there's a possibility they'll get more guys? Reinforce.
Absolutely. And so will we.
Now, wait a minute. Let's think about this. How many will they bring? 2, 3, 10, maybe more?
They'll bring as many as they can recruit.
Well, because they'll figure we'll probably get as many as we can recruit.
Not just recruit, trust.
That's it. Trust. That's the word. Trust. We could recruit the whole goddamn town, but who can we trust? And we're going to have to make a list of all those men that we can trust.
No bleeding 4Fs.
That's right.
What about George Pomeroy?
George is good.
Is Charlie Foote?
Charlie's fine. Any of the men in the club are good.
What about your security chief at the store?
Hey, wait a minute. You mean that black guy? What's wrong with that, Zeke? We're talking about men, Zeke. Real men. We're not playing games, Zeke. We're talking about a firefight. We need all the men we can trust. Equipment. I want every man to have a gun, tin pot, flak jacket.
Helmets and armor. Where in the hell are we going to get stuff like that? You got the Sarge over a barrel.
Well, Major, why don't we take that M60 tank we got in the motor pool?
What kind of weapons do you think they'll bring, Major?
I don't know, Pete. But I know we're going to get every automatic weapon we can lay our hands on.
I'm not going to be caught with a goddamn pea shooter.
Well, I'm sure as hell going to take my Tommy gun.
That's the only way.
We're very fortunate this morning, gentlemen, in having someone with us who is peculiarly equipped to help us with our logistic problem.
Hello, baby. You got enough automatic ship to equip the Chinese brigade?
Yeah, Lou. And this is your chance to put it all to good use.
Not only that, he's the town's number one expert on submachine guns and assault rifles. And he even lectures at gun clubs all over this fine state.
Lou, suppose, just suppose, I were to put you in charge of automatic weapons and enough ammo, say, 100,000 rounds.
100,000 rounds?
Is that a problem? I'm paying for it, Lou.
No problem.
Good. Good.
Very well, gentlemen. There are no more questions. Now remember, we want that list tomorrow. We rendezvous Saturday at dawn.
Understood? Saturday morning, dawn. Dismissed.
Oh, wait a minute. Listen to me. What the hell's the matter with you guys? Nobody's gonna be there. Don't you understand? Nobody's gonna be there. You guys are letting this thing run away with you. My God. 100,000 rounds of ammunition, helmets and automatic weapons for what? You talk about killing and shooting like it was a game. Like homicidal maniacs. For Christ's sake. Can't you understand? I love you guys. And I don't want to see any of you killed. So why? Why do you want this slaughtered?
We're trying to prevent a slaughter, Lou. Not cause one. But if one of those guys fires one shot, just one shot, God help him.
No. God better help you. Because you want it to happen.
Next week, huh?
Yeah, sure.
Good. Sarge, want to take up your shoes?
No. Touch of Paula.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think she's out of the work mood again.
Good, Bob. Glad to hear it.
Yeah. We'll see you.
Sarge. Got your pad and pencil?
Yes.
I want you to write down a few things we're going to need for maneuvers this weekend.
Sir.
I want everything organized by dawn Saturday morning. You got that?
Sir.
Okay, I want the following. Flak jackets, 20. Steel helmets, 20. With camouflage netting. How many automatic weapons do you have?
18, sir.
18, I want them all. 5,000 rounds each one. You still have that BAR in the basement?
Yes, sir.
5,000 rounds for the BAR. Hand grenades, one case. Make that two cases hand grenades. Five players. Five walkie-talkies. I want them all in the six by. Saturday morning dawn. Sergeant.
This is not going to be easy, Major.
Oh, it's going to be easy, Sergeant. These are maneuvers, Sergeant. Besides, anybody who could sell as many carbines on the side as you've been shouldn't find any trouble in this little operation.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
See you Saturday. We've been talking to Lou.
Yes. He called me last night. I'm begging you, Rex. You know how I had always begged you to let me hang on? Well, I won't do it. I won't ask it anymore if you'll just stay home today, please.
Take over the list. news, Major. No flak jackets. Bellis, we gotta pack them.
Shit.
Okay. For those of you who've never been up here before, my cabin's about 2 miles on up above the lake. Now, that's gonna be our base. We're gonna go up there, check it out. After we check it out, we're going on the other side of the hill, about a mile, on down the Saddle River. Right down the hill. Now, most of you are veterans. All of you are veterans. Some of you are combat veterans. So I don't have to tell you to keep your eyes peeled, all right? A while ago, you might have noticed some tracks on the road. Whoever made those tracks was here less than an hour ago. All right, saddle up on the double.
This way.
Is that who I think it is? Old chicken shit? Jesus, it's chicken shit himself. Hey, we all know him, don't we? He's the one that didn't want to come along.
Tell that smart ass to shut up.
And now here he is holding up the whole war while the chicken shit's down the road.
Shut up.
I want to go in with you.
Change your mind again.
I want to go in with you.
We've all been buddies for a long time.
Bring anything with you?
Truck loaded for bear.
Let's go.
A chance.
All right, two flanking units. Security the other side of the cabin. On the double. You all right? Need any help?
Go.
We'll keep you covered.
Won't take you long to find out if it's hot.
You got the keys?
Got them.
Yeah. Make a recce down by the river. Make an area sweep.
See any action, get on the floor right away.
Right.
You got a helmet?
No, it's supposed to move.
All right, move it.
Sit back. Get near the zone where it happened.
Getting near the zone area.
We're near the place. Almost there.
Right here, man. Getting near the zone. Getting close.
Zeke, do you read? Are you all right, Zeke?
So you don't mind a poor country boy asking what the hell we're doing here, do you, Major?
I don't give a goddamn what you do, Flat. As long as you keep your mouth shut.
Okay, Major.
Zeke, you all right? Is it clean over there? That means nobody's on this side, right? This order to go to the other side, but be careful, yeah?
So is anybody
over there? Down.
Yeah, and I'm telling you, Colonel, to go screw yourself. I mean, there's nobody anywhere around here. There's nobody back there. There's nobody on this side of the river. And there's nobody on that side, sir. So up yours, Major. Hey, Stoney! Gary! Come on down! Hey, look at me! Ain't I a hot shot, frontline grunt? Have you ever saw one? In my little tin pot, huh? One more step and I blow your fucking head off. Yeah, now, we're gonna show the Major here how we could have come out here today with slingshots and a BB gun.
know why? Because there's nobody there!
Sometimes when the doctors stand around my bed and talk about the things they've done to me, I can almost make out their faces. But most of the time, it's like staring across a field of snow. Anyway, I'd rather keep my eyes closed, because I've been like this for a long time. But I got off easy compared to the others. Pete. Bob, see, Lou, God, I wish I had him back. If only we could go back together and do it right. If only we'd gotten there first, then we could have cut them to pieces, those bastards.